So instead of a home improvement video, I'm gonna do a bike racing video. So I rode the 2023 Salida 76 gravel race in Colorado. Here's the course map and profile. It's a total of 76 miles with 7,000 feet of elevation gain. The elevation ranges from 7,000 to 10,000 feet above sea level. Only the first 65 miles are timed, as the final descent back to Salida is considered a neutral section, which is undoubtedly safer. In case you don't know where Salida is, or Colorado, hopefully you know where Colorado is, but here's a zoomed out map. It's about 150 miles southwest of the city of Denver. So the race course is mostly in South Park, which is a high mountain valley. And yes, that's the same South Park in the cartoon. So I raced Salida 76 with some friends. One friend in particular is Mark. He finished in 7th place out of 251 riders, whereas I finished in 118th place. So as I was comparing our power outputs on some key climbs, it was crazy and totally coincidental that we really had a very similar power outputs on the climbs, at least. Of course, Mark went a lot faster than me since he's a much smaller rider. Specifically, he's 8 inches shorter and about 60 pounds lighter. So that's about 27% lighter than I am currently. So I looked at 23 Strava segments, and I compared Mark's power and time to mine. So all these segments were uphills, and the average grade on those uphills varied from 1.6 to 8.4%. There were obviously short stretches that were much steeper than this, but in Strava, the minimum length of a segment is one third of a mile to make for more consistent timing. So with this data, I can easily compute the average speed over the segment. Our average power was almost always within 5% on each segment, but I applied a simple speed correction to kind of normalize the my speed for the difference in power, either up or down. So with that information, I can then compare Mark's average speed over the segment to mine and look at how, on a percentage basis, how much faster did he go than I did, and plot it. So everybody knows that as the grade steepens, the lighter rider is going to have an advantage. But how much of an advantage? That's the key question. That's why I'm making the video. I plotted the speed advantage versus the grade of the hill. At the lower grade, the speed advantage, at least for these two particular riders, is 10 to 20%. At the steeper grades, it's 25 to 35%. You'll definitely notice some outliers where Mark, even at the kind of the middle grades, where Mark was going a lot faster than me at the same power. There's an explanation for this. So the race starts with a long climb, and although the neutral start, the police car did a neutral lead out and did his best to blow up the field by going really fast, but still there was a lead group of fast riders that was certainly able to stay together for most of that hill. And Mark is a very good wheel sucker. So even though he was going 10 miles an hour, that's still plenty fast enough to have some benefit from the draft. So after that initial climb, there was a steep and pretty technical descent, followed by 30 to 40 miles of muddy roads. So Mark may have been able to surf wheels somewhat after the first hill, but the field was certainly far less cohesive, so there's less of a draft effect. So I was going much slower, and I essentially didn't draft anybody for the entire ride except for a 5 mile section around mile 30, and it was just two guys in front of me. It was a pretty terrible course for drafting. It was either going up or going down, and it was pretty technical with mud all over. The 35, 40 miles of the course was essentially mud, or a small single track line through the mud. So when I subtracted the points that were on the initial climb, you can see how the curve fit definitely gets a lot tighter. So the red curve is the trend line from the previous graph where I had all the points included, including the ones where Mark was drafting. So if you kind of just look at the shift in the trend lines, it looks like drafting was giving Mark about a 2 to 4% additional speed advantage over me, which is pretty significant even on a hill. So if it was in a flat, it would be a bigger speed advantage. So as I said, this course has no flats. So to kind of I had to extrapolate the curve back to the flat grade to kind of make some conclusions. So I would guess that Mark would go about 10% faster than me on a flat grade if we were holding the same power. And this is probably due mostly to aerodynamics more than weight, as I'm much taller than Mark and I have a bigger aerodynamic cross section. It's very interesting that as the grade steepens past 5%, the light rider's advantage doesn't seem to get larger than about 27%. This was counterintuitive to me. I would have guessed that the steeper the climb gets, the lighter rider is going to have an increasing advantage over the heavier rider, but that doesn't seem to be the case, actually. So the specific comparison I made was for a heavy rider, me, versus a 27% lighter rider, which is Mark. If the heavy rider was only 15% heavier than the light rider, then the speed advantage would presumably shift down something like this. So in summary, on the steep grades, where aerodynamics go out the window, the 27% lighter rider went about 27% faster. The fact that these two numbers line up is a coincidence, but it's nice because it's easy to kind of remember and wrap around your head. So in summary, all this video really tells you is how badly your skinny friend is going to kick your ass on a hill. A more interesting video would be where the light and heavy riders ride together up the same hill at the same time at the same speed, and to see how much more power a heavy rider has to hold to keep up with his skinny friend. If we got lucky, we might find that the 20% speed advantage would imply that the heavier rider needs a 27% more power to match his friend. I'm not sure that's true, but if I had to increase my power on the big hill by 27%, then instead of 230 watts, I would have to hold 292 watts. So that kind of gives you a sense of the details may be wrong, but if you're asking yourself the question of how much more power you have to push, yeah, it's quite a bit more power. So anyway, hope you enjoyed this video. Maybe we'll get out and do some other comparisons, but it was kind of fun, fun just to put numbers to something we already knew, which is light riders go faster than heavy riders up the hill. Okay, see you later.